टीसी नंबर 355 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट। सर आई वॉज सेइंग दैट द इंडियन एयरलाइंस कॉरपोरेशन इज रनिंग एट अ ग्रेट लॉस एंड द स्कीम दैट हैज़ बीन प्रिपेयर्ड डज नॉट प्रोमिस एनी इम्प्रूवमेंट्स इन द अर्निंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द एयरलाइंस कॉरपोरेशन। वेन वी आर एम्बार्किंग ऑन आवर एक्सपेंशन स्कीम द रिजल्ट मे बी दैट इफ ड्यू केयर इज नॉट टेकन इन द बिगिनिंग एंड इफ स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन इज नॉट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द लॉसेज मे माउंट अप। दस मोर ऑफ द टैक्स पेयर्स मनी मे बी वेस्टेड इन द एयरलाइंस कॉरपोरेशन। Therefore, sir, I request the Honorable Minister to be very careful and scrutinize all the expenditure incurred with respect to the Indian Airlines Corporation and the Aviation Department and see that there is no waste. Sir, the Honorable Finance Minister in his budget speech wanted great care to be taken so that there was no wastage in the government's expenditure. I would in this connection like to know from the minister in charge of this bill what steps are being taken by the government to see that there is no wastage in the aviation department. The Air India International is, of course, running at some profit, but it is purchasing 3 more Boeings, and if the present level of travel is not maintained, there is every livelihood that the Air India International may change its profit into loss. Therefore, the Honorable Minister has to be very careful about it. Then, sir, I come to items number 19 and 20 which relate to the Ministry of Education and Archaeology. Here, sir, I would like to draw your attention to the directive principles laid down in our constitution, where it has been stated that within a certain limited period, adult education and complete literacy will be attained. I am surprised to find, sir, that for this purpose, the amount sanctioned is very meager. The finances of the states are limited. Their sources of income are limited, and what they get from taxes is mostly spent on maintaining law and order and on other items like judiciary and civil administration, etc. And therefore, unless the central government comes to the rescue of the states in the matter of education, I do not think there will be any substantial progress in this respect. I am sure that the Honorable Minister will say that education is a state subject and it is not, therefore, the responsibility of the center. Then, sir, I come to the item pertaining to the External Affairs Ministry. In this connection, I would like to submit that I am very glad that the Honorable Prime Minister has made his stand very clear about Kashmir and I wholeheartedly welcome it. I am very glad to find that at long last, after 2 years, he was stated the stand of India clearly. And therefore, I wholeheartedly support the expenditure pertaining to the Ministry of External Affairs. I would like to know in this connection only one thing, although it does not really come under this ministry. It comes under the Ministry of Finance. I would like to know the steps taken by the Finance Minister about the settlement of the loan due to India from Pakistan. Some 2 years back, the Honorable Finance Minister had taken a credit entry of nearly rupees 18 crores as 2 installments of the loan payment by Pakistan. I should call it the pre-partition debt. But that money was not received by India and that amount is still due from Pakistan. I would like to know from the Finance Minister why this amount of rupees 18 crores was shown as the loan paid by Pakistan. We have done our part of the bargain because in 1950 when Pakistan wanted its share of the cash balances of the Reserve Bank, India immediately paid rupees 55 crores to Pakistan towards its share of the cash balance. But Pakistan has not kept its part of the bargain. Therefore, I would like to know the steps taken by the Finance Minister to recover the debts due from Pakistan. There are so many other outstanding amounts due from Pakistan for which the Finance Minister does not seem to have taken any proper steps. There is a continuous trade going on between India and Pakistan. There is plenty of transfer of funds between India and Pakistan. The Honorable Finance Minister can take certain steps so that the exchange authorities which are transferring the amounts from one country to the other country can also bring pressure and help us in recovering the amounts. Probably the Honorable Minister, being a lawyer, may be thinking along judicial lines, but I never thought along those lines. I did not suggest that we should ask for a degree from the Hague because that is quite impracticable. But there is a practical method of doing it, and that is through trade between the two countries. Then I come to the subject of grants in aid to the states. Sir, more of these grants are made to the state governments.